said vengeance is his, but I'ma do it first. I'm gonna handle my business in the name of the law.
Absolutely, there's a culture. Absolutely. There's different levels to it as well. I mean, you've got the levels where it's, you know, kind of high end up your arse. Pardon my English, but I mean, so there's definitely a hierarchy or a level of attitude throughout the tattoo industry that is, it's more apparent now because the artwork's been pushed up. The level of skill of artwork is never seen anything like it. And that's what's pushed the stakes up, you know? You've got to be good in the game. If you're not, you're going to go under, simple as that.
And if you're covered in tattoos, then you have to embrace that lifestyle because you aren't going to get looked at differently and kind of asking for it, so you have to embrace it. And people are going to ask you questions and touch you, and especially if you're a girl, because people aren't used to seeing heavily tattooed women. Yeah, probably. I don't think so. I think most of the general reaction is that, you know, you're a bit of a slut, really. Or that, you know, you're alternative. And they don't take you seriously, I don't think. But, yeah.
Great. I think it's like social stereotypes. They want women to be little, pretty women. They don't want women to be covered in big tattoos and that. But it's slowly getting there now that they don't care. I think there's a certain amount of people look at them and go, wow, I'm just, you know, you've kind of had the bravery to do it. Whereas men, they just kind of go, yeah, all right. It is a bit like that. It almost seems to be braver for a woman to get tattooed than a man.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah, I think so. I think there's still that hierarchy where you've probably got the older set of tattoo artists that don't agree or don't think women should be tattooing. I've experienced that, you know.
I think recently it is changing. I think 10 years ago, definitely not. But, yeah, maybe not in this studio.
Well, fine.
Yeah, I think it's definitely they've been taken more seriously and they're doing amazing work.
Absolutely so. I mean, you only have to look at a lot of celebrities that it trickles down through into the masses. Cheryl Cole, for example, you know, she's got one just on the hand here. And it's like a fashion trap, as it were. You see all the girls getting it's like, lambs to the slaughter, the cheekies, you know, all getting the same tattoo, do you know what I mean? David Beckham as well, with the cross on his back, the crucifix. Loads of lads about that.
Once there seems to be something new. So at the moment it's feathers and little birds and dream catchers and infinity symbols, and then next year it'll be probably like mandalas and Indian designs are getting more popular, so you definitely see.
So everything I had an animal with a monocle, and no one has that anymore, but everyone had it a few years ago. That's the sort of trends that sort of show up and then disappear again.
I think we're moving away from a society where tattoos are tabooed, and I think that we're moving towards a state of bodily freedom, and that's kind of the best way to go, because we're all individual and we have the right to mark our skin as we like.